Okay, so I recently did a longer video on all things scrolling timeline, and if you missed it, link in the description. And promptly after having it up, believe it or not, I realized that on one hand, I forgot a few things that I should have included, but also something that I wasn't aware of yet at the time. So I figured I'd do a quick addendum to the main video to quickly cover said points. Some of the comments I got on the first video made me realize my first omission, where some were saying that it's too bad that there's no easy or quick on-off switch, and I actually mentioned this in the follow-up video on collapsing connected clips. I just thought I'd repeat it here if you haven't seen it, because there is in fact a new freely assignable keyboard command for the scrolling. If you open the command editor with Alt-Command-K and enter scroll in the search field, you'll see the timeline scrolling command listed, which has no shortcut assigned by default. To assign it a shortcut, you simply select it, select or create a custom command configuration, and enter the desired shortcut on your keyboard. For example, Control-Option-Command-S. And it appears behind the command as the new shortcut. Or you simply drag the command from the list to whatever key you want to assign it to, say for example the F8 key. And now you even have two shortcuts that you can use. Now I just click save, close the command editor, and I can now simply press my shortcut during playback to turn it on and off. Perfect. Then, after only comparing Final Cut's scrolling to Premiere Pro, someone said, "Big whoop, I've had this in Resolve for years." So, I wanted to see what exactly they were talking about since I hadn't paid attention to Resolve in quite some time. What's it like there? Well, at least partially better than in Premiere. When you start playback, the playback position runs to the right edge and jumps. That is, unless I've completely overlooked something, Resolve's timeline doesn't scroll at all. It simply jumps. So I have no idea how this qualifies as scrolling in some people's minds. Feel free to let me know in the comments if I'm doing something wrong here, but I'm pretty sure I'm not. But hey, at least you can switch on more than just one thumbnail image per clip, unlike Premiere. And what happens when you playback now? Except for audio waveforms, nothing. And when you stop playback, surprise, surprise, everything refreshes. That looks very familiar. Oh, and as with Premiere's scrolling timeline, don't you dare try to edit anything. I have no idea how you can allow something like this, but if you make the same mistake during playback, that is, click on an edit point or a title, for example, and the playhead scrolls out the right of the window, this happens. Pretty unbelievable in my opinion. How can that be? And any attempt to scroll past the playhead annoyingly jumps the window back and forth, too. Just like in Final Cut, you say? Well, yes, but no. We'll get to that in a second. Okay, but there is a second scrolling in the cut page in Resolve. I personally find this even more useless and annoying. If you play something here, you get this static always in the middle thing. Scrolling left and right actually works, but not only the window scrolls, but the playhead as a whole. Huh? I don't get it. And trying to edit something during playback, be it in the large or small timeline, forget it. Just as dangerous. Without stopping playback first, I wouldn't recommend clicking anywhere or anything. Worst of all, at least in the edit page, you can't even switch it off. So what were people thinking of when they mysteriously put this, of all things, at the top of their wish list? Who wants or wanted this, and who actually uses it? Seriously. Okay, so how does one do this intelligently, and most of all, both in a useful and safe way? Well, surprise, surprise, look no further than Final Cut. While I showed that you can easily edit things like edit points and audio levels in my last video, what I unfortunately failed to point out were two very significant details. For one, if you hadn't noticed yourself, if I do something like I showed you in Premiere or Resolve, namely click and hold a clip or title, for example, the timeline not only stops scrolling for as long as I'm holding onto whatever it is, but the playhead can even scroll out the right side and nothing happens. Final Cut stops everything until I'm finished with whatever I'm doing, and once I let go of the mouse, it jumps back to where the playhead is to center it. Now, that's a smart and most of all, non-disastrous implementation. But believe it or not, there's even an enhanced version of this, if you will. Because if you have the Clip Skimmer active, which I normally have active at all times, all you have to do is move the mouse over any clip in the timeline without clicking, and the scrolling stops again. This allows me to search for whatever edit point or volume control that I want to edit at my leisure, and I don't have to worry in the slightest that something will get all messed up unintentionally, something I actually do all the time while reviewing an edit. I'll decide the audio I just heard could be a couple of decibels higher or lower, or I can even leisurely add some keyframes without having to bring everything to a screeching halt. So really, an incredibly intelligent implementation of a seemingly so trivial feature. The Final Cut team never ceases to amaze me. Then I even came across the near 100% solution to my alleged shortcoming where I lamented that I'm only missing a refresh for when I manually scroll the timeline, which I thought impossible if the scrolling was active. But while using this for my daily edits, I suddenly realized if I use the Clip Skimmer to skim over whatever, say for example the primary, so that the scrolling stops, then I can actually scroll left and right with the magic mouse, or shift and scroll wheel with any other mouse, beyond the playhead's position. And all waveforms and filmstrips are also updated as I go, even if it does jump back when I move the mouse somewhere else. But that's enough for me at this point, so I take everything back. Basically, I get exactly what I was looking for, even if the option is anything but obvious. But this is, for me, the only smart and actually useful version of a scrolling timeline compared to any of the others that I've seen. Looks like I could leave it permanently enabled after all. And last but not least, I also forgot to point to a small but, in my opinion, extremely useful advantage to activating the scrolling timeline in the context of multicams. Something that has secretly really kind of annoyed me for a while now, and is possibly relevant for those that edit a lot of multicams and perhaps don't want to switch on the scrolling otherwise. Those people will know that until now, whenever you made an edit to your multicam during playback, nothing was updated here either. You only ever saw the film strip and waveform of the very first clip. After that, there was no refresh again until you stopped playback. Nothing horrible, just not really elegant. But now, if you activate the automatic scrolling, go back and make your edits, all the film strips and waveforms of every new camera angle are refreshed during playback. Hooray! So those were my four things I had to point out about this seemingly so simple feature. Are you glad I did it? Was any of it useful to you? Give us a like if it was. Or maybe you already knew it all. Do you love the scrolling timeline like me, or do you not care either way, as I used to? Let me know down in the comments. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you in the next one.